Hello and welcome to the Non-League Show. Today we'll bring you extended highlights of Burgess Hill Town versus Kingstonian. Now today is Ryman Community Day and we're expecting a bumper crowd here, and it's fair to say that both teams need all the support they can get as they occupy the two places immediately above the relegation zone. Now, when you look at the form book, it's not hard to see why these two teams are struggling as they are, with a one win combined between their last 19 league games. It's fair to say it's been a bit of a horror show as far as league form is concerned. Now, this is actually the first part of a double header as these two teams meet again in 9 days' time. So let's see tonight who gets first blood. So here with a couple of Hillians, in fact, family Hillians, father and son, Andy and Aaron. How long have you been coming down here?
About four seasons now. So lived in Burgess Hill all my life. I used to come down when I was a youngster, about 16, but it's only the last 4 years that I've had the opportunity to come down and bring my son down so he can enjoy it as well.
And you say enjoy, have you been enjoying it?
I have, very much so, yeah. Yeah, it's very good. Good football for the standards, yeah. Good players as well, yeah. Very good, yeah, very enjoyable.
Yeah. And what would you say has been the highlight of the four seasons so far?
Oh, it's when we won the championships and we went up to the divisions. It's been a bit tough the last couple of seasons, and especially this season at the moment, it's a bit touch and go at the moment. It's all like fifth from bottom at the moment, so hopefully get a good result today. We really need a good result today.
Certainly the last few games, performances have actually picked up. It's just been the results that haven't quite gone their way.
Tuesday night, we battled hard on Tuesday night, 89th minute, the goal. We didn't deserve that. A point would have been a fair result for both teams, I believe.
So, our young friend, I'm going to leave you with a prediction. What do you think the score's going to be today?
I think we'll come away with the win, 3-1. Yeah.
3-1, I like it. Good stuff. All right, thanks very much. We'll find out later. So you can see behind me here, we've got it's actually quite a good cause today, raising money for Comic Relief as part of the 50-50 raffle. It's just the different things that we do in non-league to help raise money, not just for the club to keep the club going, but also in this case for a wonderful cause. And as you can see, raffle tickets being bought. Lepensia, maybe that's the winner right there, who knows? So I'm here with Kingstonian fans. Have travelled down today, Bob and Steve. What time did you set off today to get down here?
Oh, not too bad at all, about 1 o'clock, so no, not bad at all. Nice drive down.
Happy day. So you didn't come on the team bus?
We did not come on the team bus.
No. Not officially in the squad, no.
No?
No. Although we might be able to get in the team, actually, at the moment, but you never know.
Current form, obviously, is not too great. How long have you been following Kingstonian?
I've been following them since way back in the 60s. So, not great at the moment, but hopefully for a good couple of results coming up, and we can pull out, I think.
Well, it's important. This is sort of the first of a double header in two games in 9 days.
Yeah.
And this could shape the season, maybe.
Well, I hope it'll have a lot to do with it. Now, after the last seven matches without a win, we could do with a serious injection of good luck.
Absolutely, no, it's all good. So you've been in the 60s, so you've seen the highlights of FA Trophy those 2 years in a row. How far away is this team from that team back in the late 90s?
It seems to be it's way different, I think. We had a bit of a taste of full-time professional football, I think, for a while. So, but it's about supporting a team's going through the good times and the bad times. The good times are even better when you've had a few bad times, so fingers crossed.
Brilliant stuff. And lastly, I'm going to ask you for a prediction. What do you think the score might be today?
2-1.
Nondescript 2-1. Just 2-1.
2-1. Of course, a 2-1 to K's.
2-1 to the K's. Well, will it be for the K's? Will it be for the Hillians? We'll find out later on in the show. So, just ahead of kickoff, then let's go through the two teams, starting with Burgess Hill Town in goal. Number one, James Shaw. Number two, Ibrahim Diallo. Number three, Leon Redwood. Number four, Toby Poynting. Number five, Captain Cheek Toure. Number six, Sam Fisk. Number seven, Pat Harding. Number eight, Pierre Hazard. Number nine, Lee Harding. Number 10, Aaron Smith-Joseph. And number 11, Lucas Rodriguez. And the substitutes for Burgess Hill Town, Jack Brivio, Teddy West, James Richmond, Guy Bolton, and Tyrell Richardson-Brown. And for Kingstonian, in goal number one, Rob Telfrey. Number two, Jordan Gibbons. Number three, Keir Jackson. Number four, Leo Leary. Number five, Charlie Westmer. Number six, Alan Innes, the captain. Number seven, Joe Turner. Number eight, Sean McCauley. Number nine, Ryan Moss. Number 10, Paleo Gomez-Pico. Number 11, Charles Banya. And the substitutes for Kingstonian, Sam Page, Sean Bonnet-Johnson, Josef Bamba, Lewis Taylor and Tom Derry. So Kingstonian will kick off and it'll be Leo Leary. Kingstonian's back four, relatively new back four, with, so we have a full start here. There's three players charged into the left hand side and that's easily cleared up the pitch and early battle for Touré. And the ball over the top and his early chance onside hit. Straight from kickoff. Oh, and that's a little fumble of the foot there from Ryan Moss. He's still got the ball at his feet though. Tries to take a man up. So a real opportunity. Ball over the top. Simple as that. Ryan Moss just lost his footing on the ground, but he's won his team a corner. Lee Harding, the man with a chance. Corner whipped in, header out, and it's in! Oh, he's in the back of the net! It's Sam Fisk with the goal inside a minute, or did it take a touch from Lucas Rodriguez? I think the way they're celebrating, I think it was his flick inside the 6-yard box, but it was Fisk's initial header from the corner. And what a start for the Hillians. They've taken the lead inside a minute here. Burgess Hill Town 1, Kingstonian 0. So there is confirmation, Rodriguez getting that flick just inside the box for the opening goal. And that will settle a few nerves. And that was a handball from Touré. A chance maybe for Kingstonian to respond straight away. A free kick 10 yards inside Burgess Hill territory. It's whipped in, cleared away from Touré. And the hesitation from Smith Joseph. Then show composure, gets the ball down the line. Good turn of feet from McCauley. Gibbons. Ball up, little flick over the top and an early chance here now for Moss with a volley. Good, important block. It's all right. Short with a high looping kick. Flicked on nicely by Harding. Pointing up to the goal scorer Rodriguez. He's showing a good little turn of pace. But eventually is held off. Looked like it was a painful one there for Innes. Caught an elbow from Harding as they went for that together. And he's going to need some attention. And it'll be good to carry on. Turn it with the ball in and headed off the line. The keeper got a tap on it and I think it was Diallo on the corner. Got his head to it and kept it from going into the top corner. And it remains 1-0. That should have been dealt with. Rodriguez sneaks in behind him. Rodriguez could make something here. He's got options. He pulls it back. It's going to be two. What a save that was. Oh, it looked for all the will in the world. Pat Hurley was going to score, but what a save from Rob Tolfrey, and he's kept the score at one. Rodriguez had snuck in behind, put it on a plate. And I'll be looking possibly for Smith Joseph. He said no, goes to pointing. He gets a cross in, Rodriguez at the back post, trying to make something of it, claiming he was held by Dixon. That's, he was the only one. Smith Joseph didn't quite get on the end of that one. Hazel keeps it alive. Oh, and that's another late challenge from pointing, and I don't think he's going to get away with it. And he's just saying to him, that's his last chance. Ball looking for Turner. He's got support behind him, Luke Gibbons. And up looking for Pico Gomez, but Fisk was there to head away. Again, Fisk with a header, and then pointing, gets it away, but only as far as Dixon. Here's Banya, held off the challenge of Diallo. Comes back to Rasmus. It's calm football for the moment, but that wasn't very calm from Touré, and Diallo had to do well there. It's short. Well done, Pico. Was put in a difficult situation. Corner whipped in, Inns was underneath it, and it's cleared away, but then come off pointing behind for another corner. Again, there's a bundle in the area, and Hazard was there to get the ball away. It's a high kick from Short. And that's nice from Harding. Over the top, looking for his fellow namesake, Pat Harding. But that's well dealt with and cleared, only as far as pointing. Pico Gomez making a nuisance of himself, but he couldn't find Banya, and that's lovely. Quick change of feet from Diallo, and plays a little ball over the top for Rodriguez. But Inns was there initially, and then hooked away by Gibbons. Pat Harding shoots. Oh, what a save again from Tolfrey. Twice Harding's been denied by wonderful saves from the keeper, Rob Tolfrey. This time it was heading into the top corner from all of 20 yards. Shaw's ball up. Pat Harding, the ball by the corner flag, gets his cross in, handed away by Wasmer. Falls only as far as Lee Rodriguez, who's he brought down? Referee's not interested. And then a free kick's given. It seemed to go over quite easily there. Young Lucas Rodriguez. Diallo up the line. And Harding's flick, Fasma. O'Leary under pressure. Good from Rodriguez, then by Harding. Then Rodriguez can turn and shoots. Just over the top from Lucas Rodriguez.
Oh.
O'Leary gets the flick on. Touré lofts it back up. O'Leary. So we have a drop ball. It's nice to see a contested drop ball pointing and then Ings over the top looking for Pico Gomez. He gets in ahead of Diala. He's in the corner. And now Harding comes in. Pico Gomez is very strong. Got his cross in. That's comfortable for sure. Up it goes, the sun getting low. It's going to see some of the players shielding their eyes as the ball came through. That was loose. And Banya up towards Pico Gomez. Moss has made the run ahead of him. It can said it comes infield to McCauley. And then they've got Gibbons and Turner. It's got O'Leary in the middle. Takes a touch immediately under pressure from Harding. But he can flick it up. Pico Gomez beaten in the air by Fisk. And then Redwoods shows calmness and composure and Hayes it. Plays the ball up looking for Harding to chase. Vasma was there though. Has it. He's getting a frustrated figure. The leading striker for Kingstonian. 19 league goals, 20 overall for the season. And he hasn't really had a look at goal today. Harding was beaten in the air by Ings. Fisk. And Fisk was there again at the back. Had it out of touch for a throw into Kingstonian midway inside Burgess Hill half. Gibbons, the long throw. Pico Gomez with the flick on. And is it going to break at the back from Moss? But what a fist that was from Shaw. Who clattered into the post at the same time. And the referee's given a free kick. And he's got the card out. And I think it's going to be for Moss. Seems a bit harsh. He looked like he had eyes for the ball. O'Leary's being sent away. And that is first yellow card of the game. And it's Ryan Moss, the man with it. Thankfully, James Shaw has received some treatment and he's okay. He did very well. Vassman was there and then over the top by pointing. Redman putting Vassman under pressure and then fouls him. Count himself a little bit fortunate there, the centre back. over his head. Diallo gets it away initially. Flick on. Rodriguez with a nifty touch over looking for Smith-Joseph. Can Burgess Hill end the half as they started it? Smith-Joseph strong against the fullback and then he's adjusted to a foul. Gibbons showing good defensive work. It's all getting a little bit scrappy. And that's the end of the first half, where Burgess Hill Town lead 1-0 courtesy of a second minute goal from Lucas Rodriguez. A cheeky little back heel 3 yards out following a brilliant fisk header from a corner. They'll certainly be the happier of the two teams going into the break. Half time score, Burgess Hill Town 1, Kingstonian 0. As we start the second half, just to remind you of a couple of changes that have just occurred. So for Kingstonian, Gomez, Pico and Banya have gone off and Bamba and Taylor have come on. As immediately Gibbons gets Kingstonian on the attack down this right-hand side. McCauley's still going on. Still keeping the ball in play. And then Fisk clear back towards Rodriguez, who used his arm. Free kick taken quickly. It's turn for one of those substitutes. Here is Taylor. Now O'Leary. Expect Kingstonian to come out with a bit of fight in this half. So Shaw's kick out Rodriguez. Try to get underneath it. Inns was there. That was a nice header from Pointing. And Harding nearly made something of it. And Rodriguez, the first shot of the second half. O'Leary claiming handball. And the second half starting out pretty much how the first half played out. Kingstonian territorially on top maybe, but not creating anything of note. The chances being created by the team in green. But that could change now as the ball is over for Moss. Here's their danger money. Holds off Fisk, goes for the lob. It's over the top of the crossbar. And that is the first real effort on goal from Kingstonian. Comes back, it's got support from O'Leary. McCauley overhit towards Bamba. Fisk. Innes wins that one in the hip. Harding. Now Rodriguez. There's a little slip and then it's clearly pushed in the back by Taylor. It's all right. It's Rodriguez. You can get the cross in. And it's in! I'm not sure how, but it's stuck in. It's an own goal, I think, from O'Leary. It seemed to go towards the back post again. And came off the defender and into the back of the net. And much like Kingstonian's equaliser, Burgess Hill Town have got a goal from nothing. Well, they're crediting the goal to Fisk on the tannoy. And what a response that is, and how Burgess Hill Town needed that one. O'Leary, now McCauley. He's the real drive and engine in the heart of this midfield for Kingstonian. Good defending from Rodriguez. Provided that wicked cross. That's a free kick in a dangerous position. Pointing gives away. And pointing there, getting yellow card. That's a tossing up process. The free kick right on the corner of the penalty spot. No, penalty box, I should say. Floated in. It's over the head. Shaw gets a fist to it. Bamba with a cross. And then Shaw grasps it on his 8-yard line. Gibbons kept his eye on that. And in his place comes Jack Brivio. Fisk wins that one ahead of Moss. And Rodriguez was allowed to bring that down and play through Harding. But that's an important foot in from Vasna. And the sun causes trouble, and Shaw takes a chest and then gets that one clear. Dixon will let that go through the keeper. So the team immediately below these two teams, the Leatherheads, who are actually only in the relegation zone because they will adopt 3 points for fielding an eligible player. Without those 3 points, Burgess Hill Town would be in the relegation zone, which makes this game even more important. And that is a crude challenge, and the referee saw that and blew straight away. Harding was going through, and it's Vasna. Gets a yellow card, and it's low, headed away initially by O'Leary, then by Turner. A slip by Harding, and there was no power behind that shot. Has it, wins the first and the second header. But O'Leary in the middle of the park, for one for Moss to chase. Torre strong at the back. Turner nearly nipped in ahead of Diallo. As we're into the last 20 minutes of a fascinating game here at the Green Elephant Stadium. 2-1 the score for the hosts in this relegation six-pointer. Brivio looked for a little ball over the top for Harding. Just had a little bit too much on it. Gibbons. But Smith-Joseph does well to block the pass. And then good recovery from the fullback after his initial error. The keeper on his weaker foot gets it clear. Bamba, Brivio, two substitutes. Redwood lofts one up. Inns can get that one away as far as has it. Somehow got it to Brivio, who tries to spread play. Spread a little bit too far. Here's Vasma. Comes inside to McCauley. Now Inns. It's just a ball up. Harding, now Smith-Joseph, and it fortunately came off Inns' chest. I don't think he knew much about it. Here's Taylor, though. He's wanting some support, and he's got it with O'Leary here. McCauley gets a foot on Torrey, held him off initially, but there's now space for Moss. Torres left probably for the first time this game, and there's a deep cross to the back post, headed back from Turner, and that wasn't quite where he wanted that to go. And Rodriguez gets it clear. And a free kick which Dixon puts in, and it's come off a Burgess Hill head, but Bamba decided to keep it in and gets a cross in and has it got an important head on, and Turner will let that roll out of play. It's a throw into Kingstonian, taken quickly. That's important from Hazard, but then flicks on in another header just over the top. And it was the centre-back Vasma who was unmarked from 8 yards out. He couldn't quite direct his header on target. And then Kingstonian make their third and final change. It's McCauley, the impressive midfielder, coming off. And Bonnet Johnson coming on. Diallo gets it back from Harding. And then a little, lovely little 1-2 Diallo. Lovely turn of feet from him. Important from Vasma, he was there. Good play between the fullback Diallo and Harding. This time it's the other Harding, Lee Harding. The keeper goes on with it early, and Taylor brings it forward, but Smith Joseph is chasing him back all the way. Taylor holds off that particular challenge, then plays a little loose pass for O'Leary, but O'Leary did get there, and Smith-Joseph has just overhit it as Turner was coming in on the blind side. Goal kick. Torrey. That one clear. Smith-Joseph was beaten by. Vasna Harding then got there for Burgess Hill Town. Bamba's got work to do here to make that work. But he's going to get onto that one. Lovely ball over the top from Taylor. Here goes Bamba. Fisk is holding him up for now. He shows a turn of foot, gets a low shot to the near post. That's well saved by Shaw. On the far side. O'Leary back to Dixon. And O'Leary's sliced ball only finds Brivio, who then's caught late by Taylor, who apologises. I'm sure we'll go back to that later as Harding takes on Gibbons, but Gibbons has got too much pace for him. And then Harding brings down Gibbons. And now the referee is going to deal with that late challenge by Taylor. That's number 17, Tyrell Richardson-Brown, that's coming on. The match sponsors there, you may have heard on the tannoy, giving the Man of the Match award to Lucas Rodriguez, and it's hard to argue with that one. And there's a slip there, and Bamba can turn. He's got space to run into as the fullback's down, and Brivio brings him down. He's already been booked, remember. Brivio And the referee's just explaining that since he's come on, he's made two tackles and both of them were fouls. And that one more and he'll be going off. So Sean Bonnet-Johnson, as the clock ticks in to stoppage time, it's high, the keeper's straight into his hands. And that's exactly what Burgess Hill Town will want. Exactly what Kingstonian don't need. And there is 4 minutes of stoppage time to be played at the end of this game as Rodriguez tries to make a nuisance of himself again. A little push on the back of Gibbons. Redwoods wins that one. Harding. Brivio. And then O'Leary. There's substitute Bonnet-Johnson, then lofted forward by Gibbons. Torre chests it. Fisk hooks it out of play for a throw. Bamba. Fullback it. Bounced high for him awkwardly. Dealt with it. O'Leary looks the ball forward. Should be easy for Torre. Anywhere seems to do now for the Hillians. That's the young substitute, Richardson Brown, making a nuisance of himself. It's Harding. And then Rodriguez gets a tip in and he could finish it here. Rodriguez on his right foot. Oh, another good save from the keeper, Telfrey. And the substitute nearly on the volley with a spectacular third. Another good save from Telfrey. But Vasma has put himself up the pitch. And here's Turner. Turner still gets a cross in. Put away for a throw in. End to end stuff here in injury time. As Burgess Hill Town try to eat up some more of the clock with their third and final change. What a chance that was to seal the game for the man of the match, Lucas Rodriguez, put through. Vasma had left the space by going up the pitch, of course. Kingstonian needing the goal. He just didn't quite get hold of it. And the score remains 2-1. And the game's on a knife edge as Rodriguez comes off. That's his James Richmond. Kingstonian fans saying attack. As we're into the third of four added minutes, and there's a, as I say, a holding from Vasma. On the substitute, Richmond, who's just come on. It's over his head. Richardson Brown. Moss gets a little push in the back, and there's a free kick just inside the Burgess Hill Town half. And everyone by the keepers inside the Burgess Hill Town half. And Vasma, the flag's up, he was offside. And that's disappointing from a Kingstonian point of view. Shaw's kick up, looking for Richardson Brown. It's over his head. O'Leary won it. Dixon, here's Taylor. Looking for Turner, but Diallo was there, getting a foot in. Oh, and here's the substitute, Richardson Brown, with a chance to seal it maybe. He goes into the box, shoots! Another save from the keeper! But for Rob Telfrey, there could have been four or five here. They look to run the clock down in the corner. And that is the end of a game. A vital 3 points for Burgess Hill Town. They climb above Kingstonian in the league. And it'll be important to see how the reverse fixture plays out in 9 days' time. The score here today, though, Burgess Hill Town 2, Kingstonian 1. So a vital 3 points, but what a perfect start.
Yeah, started the game, obviously get a goal in the first minute or so, and then to be fair, we haven't 15, 20 minutes, we ain't really got involved in the game. Always going to be difficult. I thought overall we had the better chances in the game, but obviously we gifted them a goal, which we can't keep doing. And we just said it in there, but overall really delighted. It's only 3 points. It's another, it's a win towards trying to get safe, but we ain't safe yet, nowhere near it, so we've still got to go again.
And you must be really pleased with the response, because as you said, their goal came from nothing. They didn't really have a chance before then, and then 5 minutes later you almost replicate that by getting a goal that you have yourself. You've got to be pleased with the response, because it did come around and sort of come back into the game after that.
Yeah, too many times this year we've give teams a lift, and we've got a young squad in numbers, it's kind of the same old story, but we've got a young squad who's learning, and for their goal, the first player don't head it. The goalie don't know whether to come. The other centre half don't deal with it. So it's three errors in one movement, and it's cost us. But to dig yourselves out of a hole, obviously to score quickly was vital, and we've done that. And obviously, once the game got stretched, we probably had the better chances. We probably had three or four chances to actually put the game to bed. But massive win today. It was really vital that we didn't get beat, and obviously we wanted 3 points more than anything else. And to get that is a real boost for us. And we got a nice week now. No game, we can train twice and look for next Saturday's game, where again it'll be another cup final for us.
So you're up against Harlow again, who you narrowly missed out, lost to on Tuesday. What's it like playing the same teams, because we've got the Kingstonian again in quick succession?
It's difficult. I don't think it's structured right. I don't think you should be playing sides straight after each other. But that's the way it's fallen. The Harlow game in the week, I'm very honest with where we are. We should have got a point. They had one chance second half and scored, and we had four or five chances like we did today. Didn't take them, and you get punished. But they're a real direct side, good at what they do, and it'd be a real hard game. But we've enjoyed that tonight because it's been a couple of weeks since we've had a win, and we've got to start again. So we train really hard this week, Tuesday, Thursday, do some shape stuff for Saturday, and then we go again.
So there we have the end of another non-league show and a crucial 3 points in the battle for survival for our host today, Burgess Hill Town. And what a start they had inside of 2 minutes. Rodriguez, the man of the match of the day, getting a cheeky back heel following Fisk's free header from a corner. Kingstonian, they probably had territorially the better of the first half, but they didn't create the chances. They all went the way of Harding, number 7 in particular, who saw his efforts twice, fantastically saved by the Kingstonian keeper. And really the second half matched the first until a sort of freakish goal. A free kick, missed one, missed two defenders, and there was Inns to head looping header over the goalkeeper, and somehow the game was 1-1. They may have deserved it, but 5 minutes later, Burgess Hill Town were back in. A freakish cross again from that man of the match, Rodriguez. And I'm, for one, certainly it was an own goal from Burgess Hill Town number 4. He'll be disappointed and they'll be disappointed. But they get a chance of revenge in 9 days' time. Can Burgess Hill Town get another 3 points on their way for survival? Well, hopefully we'll catch it here and all the action on the non-league show.